Who has been the most important person in your life? And can you tell me about him or her?
One of my grandparents.
Okay, and why?
Well, she had good ideas on everything, and our business relations worked out well.
Did you guys have a family business?
Yes.
And what was it?
Well, we have it still. It's a ranch in Uvalde County, a large ranch.
Family owned and run.
It's still family owned and run. It is about 18,000 acres, and it has a Frio River running all through it.
Wow. Did you grow up on that ranch?
Well, another piece of property just a way down the road was flat land, and that was known as the farm. And I grew up on the farm until I started to school, and the schools out there were pretty minimum then. And my grandparents that lived in Austin were getting quite elderly, and you didn't have homes for people then, so my mother and daddy had to commute back and forth as she took care of my grandparents.
Can you tell me a little bit more about was it your grandmother that you think it was your most?
Yes, my father's mother.
Father's mother.
Yes. She was a very, as I recall, a very strong person. She had lots of good ideas, and she ended up being sort of the ranch manager.
Wow. And around what years was she most active on the ranch?
Oh.
You can decade ballpark it.
Well, I was in the fourth grade, so that must have been...
What year were you born?
1923. June 20th, 1923.
So probably would have been around the 30s then.
Yes, yes. And the Great Depression was going on then, as they called it.
Right. And how did that impact your family?
Well, kind of a funny way. There were lots of things you couldn't buy and lots of things that were rationed. And one of them was shoes because of the leather.
Right.
And I remember my shoes got a little snug at the toes. And you couldn't buy shoes. You had to have coupons. And so Daddy took a razor blade to him in the summertime and said he was making me a pair of sandals. So he cut out the toes and some on the sides. And
what would you say was the happiest moment of your life?
Oh, well, I think I've led a very happy life. I would be difficult to pick out just a moment. Because I try to lead a good life and sort of go by the golden rules. And
that's a good one. And what is your earliest memory?
I guess when I was little and it would rain and they would let me go out and play in the rain.
What do you remember about that?
Squishing the mud between my toes.
That sounds like a lot of fun. Was that on the farm?
Yes.
Do you have children?
Yes. I bore two and raised five.
Oh, wow.
No, my first husband died, and he had two, and then I remarried, and he had some, so I raised five altogether.
Wow. That's quite a family. How did that dynamic work?
Oh, it worked out. It worked out great.
That's good. So are you 95, Sue?
Yes.
Okay. Quite something.
Yeah.
Who has been the kindest to you in your life?
My children are all very, very kind to me and come to see me often. And
do they live locally?
Some do and some don't. Some live in towns not far away, and a couple of them live here, and they've married and have, I have a very nice daughter-in-law that doesn't live too far from here. And my son, of course.
Right. And how would you describe your childhood?
Well, I think after grade school is no longer childhood, really. Think you're twice as grown up as you are.
That's probably pretty true.
But I had a great childhood, lived out on the ranch.
What was your favorite part about the ranch?
I guess riding horses. I loved that.
Did you guys have a lot of horses?
Oh, they had a few horses, but mostly it was a cattle ranch, so they just had horses that were work horses, rounding up cattle and things like that.
Do you remember any of the stories that your elders used to tell?
Grandparents that lived out there said when they were little that the black bears lived on the mountain. There was the house, and then going sloping down to the Frio River, and then shortly thereafter a big hill. And the black bears lived up there. So at night, they always were sure to put the wooden shutters closed so the light wouldn't attract the bears. But I wasn't around, so that's just tales they told.
So you don't remember seeing a lot of bears?
No, I didn't see any bears. Well, we had a de-scented skunk that was a pet.
Oh, how interesting.
And that was very nice. But we had him up here in Austin. His name was Rosie. And my husband was always taking him. He had a little harness he wore. And he was always taking him down to the service station or the grocery store or wherever he was taking Rosie with him. And so one time he was down here at the station on Bee Cave Road, and something frightened, and he had Rosie out showing him around like he always did, and something scared Rosie, and she jumped out of her little harness and ran down in the creek, and we never could find her. And I felt bad about the fact that we had descended her, so she really had no protection. That was the end of Rosie, as far as we knew.
And did you work while you were?
I'm a graduate nutritionist from the University of Texas.
Oh.
And I have worked at what was University Junior High then as a dietitian. And then I worked at Pease Elementary School as a dietitian.
Did you like your work?
Oh, I loved it.
How long were you in the field?
Well, I don't suppose you ever get out of the field. I mean,
Are you still dietitianing?
Well, I often get asked questions and stuff that comes out. You know, the vitamins were just being discovered back then. So I try to keep up with that sort of thing.
You said you were married twice?
Yes.
Okay. How did you meet your first husband?
Oh, in high school.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you were high school sweetheart.
Mm-hmm. And then the war came along, and he was in the Navy. And so went out eventually to California and San Diego and on up to Portland, Oregon.
And then how long were you all married?
I don't know.
Long time.
Quite a few years.
Quite a few years. And then he passed.
Then he passed. And, he was still alive when we divorced, but he passed. Shortly thereafter, he's no longer living.
Oh, I see.
Neither is my second husband.
Okay. And how did you meet your second husband?
Oh, well, back then it was a a much smaller community, and I don't know, you met at parties or mutual friends or nothing special. But then that was during, which war was that anyway?
Two.
We ended up, he was in the Navy and had a LST, I believe, landing craft, something or other, and he was commander of that. He had to take that through the, to get it up on the West Coast where it could possibly fight the Japanese. He had to take it through the Panama Canal because it was in Corpus. So he did that, and we ended up in Washington State. In
like the northern part of
The
West.
And we were up there for about 3 years, which as far as I was concerned was 3 years too long. The climate up there is...
You did not enjoy the Northwest.
Oh, the climate's terrible.
It's a little scary.
They were thinking about opening the swimming pools on July the 4th.
Oh, wow.
And that just really blew my mind.
Wow. Do you remember what year you started college?
Well, probably right after I graduated from high school, which would have been, they had a big ROTC unit there then, probably, and I would have been 17, so, I mean, I went to the university right after I graduated, and so, mm-hmm. I mean.
And what was your college experience like?
Oh, it was a lot of fun and busy and studying and.
Mm-hmm. So you enjoyed it?
Oh yeah, sure did.
And how did you decide to go into your line of work?
I guess I thought it was very interesting, something that I could always carry through.
What did you think you were going to be when you grew up? Did you have an idea when you were little what you wanted to do?
Oh, no.
What lessons would you say your work life taught you?
Well, mostly I've tried to live by
the golden rule.
Yeah, I guess so. That sounds awfully goody-goody, and I don't think, I don't mean for it to.
If you could do anything now, what would it be? Would you have done the same thing?
Oh, yeah.
You liked it that much?
Yeah, well, it's...
And what was your balance with working and having a family?
It seemed to went along fine.
It was fine? Weren't too many challenges?
No, not really. I mean, the kids were all... Apparently, as far as they let me know, they were very good. We didn't have any great problems.
That is good. What about hobbies? Did you have any hobbies? Like I quilt.
Oh, uh-huh. My mother did a lot of that, and I used to help her a little bit. She did the one where you have cut out the little pieces into sixes, I guess, and then put them all together, and I used to do that. I did that more to help her. It didn't really
interest you.
No.
So I'm guessing you didn't keep doing it once you got older.
No, but I used to love to go to the ranch and ride horses and hunt deer as well as dove, and I always had some girlfriends come out and spend a few days. It was about a 2.5 hour drive from Austin. And we used to do the rodeo thing, you know, where you do the barrel thing.
The barrel racing?
Yeah, we had this nice big flat area. And we'd take those oil drums, about so big and so high, and we'd set those up there. And that would be our course, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Did you ever do that, like, on the circuit or anything, or you just
did
that?
No, no, just for fun.
So it sounds like you were kind of an outdoorsy person.
Well, yeah, I think so.
Yeah. Like the horses, and you liked to hunt.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I found that very interesting.
So you grew up on the farm. Around what year did you move full-time to Austin? Was it when you went to college that you just ended up staying?
No, it was long before that, but we still went back there in the summertime.
So you moved eventually with them?
I went to school fourth grade out there, and that was the only time I went.
Okay, so then after that,
yeah,
you guys were in Austin.
Then, yes.
Okay, so that
was... I was in school then, that was another draw to have to be up here.
Right. So then that would have been around the early 30s?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So you've seen Austin change quite a bit then.
Oh, have I ever.
What would you say has been the biggest change?
The population.
It has grown quite a lot, hasn't
mm-hmm.
it?
Mm-hmm. Quite a lot.
Are there any places you remember going to that you enjoyed that aren't around anymore?
You mean like restaurants or?
Yeah, something like that.
Oh, well, I guess I evolved with the rest of them. So, you know, El Rancho and places like that are no longer around.
And what would you say was your favorite place to go to in Austin growing up?
Well, when you had dates or even after we were married, right across the bridge going south on what they call the Avenue, right on the left was a nightclub called the Tower. And that's where everybody went to go dancing or if you had a date.
Okay.
And then there was another one way north on the highway going out there now, and I can't think of the name of it. But those were the only two places that you could go party or go dancing or have a date or something.
What kind of music were they playing at that time?
Oh, sort of swing and Tommy Dorsey and...
Right.
Yeah. And then the Jitterbug Dance was very popular.
Did you like dancing?
Oh, yeah.
Do you remember how to jitterbug?
Well, probably if I had to. You got to have on your saddle Oxfords and your poodle skirt. But that was a good high school dance thing.
Sounds like a lot of fun.
Yep, it was.
Are there any other things you can think of that you would like to share before we wrap up?
Well, I don't know.
It sounds like you've lived a really full life.
I have, and I've enjoyed every bit of it, and they tell me I'm 95 years old.
Yes, you are. You're the age, actually, that my grandmother would be if she were still alive.
Well, I was a little leery about coming over here to live, but I was plumb tired of cooking. And that's one of the main things that drew me, because I had an acquaintance or two over here, and they said, oh, they had very good food, and they do.
Good. And a plus.
Yep, so I decided to make the move. The traffic had gotten so bad that I only drove a few places.
Right.
So this seemed to be a good answer.
Well, thank you so much, Sue.
Well, you're just quite welcome.